Hello, good people of the Notion community. This is Matt or Mr. Bio, and I'm here to give you a quick tour of the Sales CRM template. So to give a little context, the entire reason why I made this template in the first place is because our marketing agency needed a better way of managing all of our leads, our entire sales pipeline, as well as projects. So with that in mind, I went ahead and made this template, and our lives have been a lot easier ever since. So if you're interested in using this template as well, let me go ahead and give you a little guide so you can see how this all works. Let's go ahead and scroll down to the contacts portion. Now, I will cover all the other portions of this template, but I want to show you the workflow that I recommend you using in order to get the most out of this template. So when it comes to this section, it's essentially your one-stop shop for all information in relation to your contacts. Now, once you create a contact, they will appear in this list right here. You can assign them a company, you can write down what their title is, the country that they reside in, their email, phone, preferred way of contact, when the last time was that you contacted them, if you want to follow up, etc. And on top of that, you can even view all of your contacts by the company that they're assigned to. Now, once you have a contact created, you can go ahead and create the company that they are a part of. So when you click this new button over here, you'll actually be given a template that you can work off. Right here, you can go ahead and put the company's website, what stage in the pipeline they are, and we'll go ahead and talk about the pipeline in a second as well, what location they're currently in, what contacts are a part of the company, any notes that you have in relation to calls that you've had with them or different meetings, as well as the projects that you're working on for them. Now, once you've gone ahead and added a contact as well as a company associated with that contact, what will happen is they will appear right here in your sales pipeline. Once a company is added to your system and they are just a lead, they will appear in this column. If you're having a conversation with them, you can go ahead and just pick this up and drag it over into the next column. And when you win their business, go ahead and drag them into the final column, which is closed one. Now, once you've won over a client, what happens next? Well, you go up here into this section where you have your projects. And regardless of if you're just a single freelancer managing all these projects or you have an entire team helping you, this project section right here will help make sure that you're tracking all the details that have to be done for this project to be completed. So for example, let's go ahead and pull up this project that says photo shoot. Now, as you can see, we've already assigned a client or a company that is related to this project that we are getting the work done for. Here you can select the status of the project so that you or everyone on your team knows what's going on. You can select the timeline for when you are going to start the project and when it needs to be completed by. You can go ahead and write down the value or the income that you are going to receive from the client once the project is complete. And then of course, you can track the progress of your project as well as who it is assigned to. Now, whenever you create a new project within this template, there will be a table right here where you can input the exact deliverables or tasks that need to be done for this project. So for example, if this is a photo shoot, we need to pick out a location, we need to hire models, we need to ship out the product that we're going to be doing the photo shoot for. And on top of that, you can assign these tasks to different members of your team. All of these things combined make sure that you're just capturing the necessary information and can make sure that you're taking care of all the details that need to be accounted for in order to make sure that the project can be completed. Now, one final thing that I want to cover is something that I added at the bottom, which is a very simple notes section. So here is where you can store any notes that are internal or external. It's really up to you. Let's say that you're having an internal meeting to go over strategy, or you're having an intro call with a new client. All of that is accounted for here, and you can record any information that you need in the notes section. And that just about wraps it up. Like I said, this was something that we wanted to create for our own agency to make sure that we could keep track of the sales pipeline as well as all the projects that we have going on. And it's been a really big help so far. If you decide to pick up the template, let me know what you think. Let me know if you have any questions, and I hope that it serves your business well. So until next time, I'll see you next time.